looks like we can rule out death by exposure. Hey, Paula.
Hi.
I'm Nar.
Can't shake your hand, I'm sorry. We will contaminate the crime scene.
Oh yeah, we don't want to do that. That's very important.
Paula Schreiber's been a film and TV prop master for 20 years. On Dexter, Paula doesn't just provide props like gloves and evidence markers, she actually creates the crime scene.
Okay, so every crime show usually has a gruesome scenario like this, and somebody has to put it together. What part do you play in it?
I'm a prop master, and prop masters play a big role in setting up a scene like this.
Paula works with forensic advisors to learn how blood spatter can reveal clues at a crime scene, including weapons used, types of injuries sustained, and movements of the victim and assailant.
So it's got to be correct according to the crime scene that we're trying to portray.
For all you low-budget filmmakers and wannabe vampires out there, strap on your aprons, because Paula's gonna teach us how to make some blood.
Kids at home, there's just 4 easy steps to a professional gore fest.
Start with this ingredient, which is your basic corn syrup.
Tell me when.
When.
All right.
That is your base.
Okay.
Now, what you do want to add to it is your food coloring. Very important. Red, of course.
Red, of course.
Enough? Stir.
Well, this looks good enough already.
Well, there are actually many different types of blood. There's blood that comes from arteries, arterial blood, or venous blood that comes from your veins. Venous blood is dark.
Okay.
Arterial blood is bright red. Also, has your blood been sitting on the surface for a while? Has
right.
it thickened? If we need to make our blood venous blood, add some chocolate syrup. Stop.
Okay.
Mix. Now, if you want a thinner blood, you add water. That's probably enough.
Okay. You know what else occurs to me is that we just put a bunch of red dye in here.
Uh-huh.
And you know, you're dealing with wardrobes and costumes.
Mm-hmm.
And you're gonna mess them up and you know, they're gonna stain, right?
There's a little trick to that.
What's the trick?
Laundry soap.
Oh, this looks great.
See,
once we added the detergent, I'm like, yeah, this looks really real.
To make edible blood, lose the detergent and swap out the corn syrup for gooey honey. Thicken to perfection with chocolate syrup and have a taste.
Tastes like undead.